Can you join me sing tonight? Hosanna, right where you are, sing in the heart. Yes, let my King believe that I. Hey, lift it up, saying, oh, Hosanna, yeah. Hosanna, in the highest, in the heart. Sing, let your King, let my King believe that I, Hosanna, sing, Hosanna.
Welcome to today's edition of Believe, and I want you to believe. It doesn't look like it, doesn't feel like it, doesn't taste like it, doesn't seem like it, doesn't seem possible to be it, but it is it. What did God say to Abraham in Genesis 17, verse 2? I will make my covenant between me and thee, and I will multiply thee exceedingly. Can you imagine? 99-year-old man had an illegitimate son called Ishmael, almost in the dying minutes of life. Somebody says, look at you. I will make of thee a great nation. I will multiply you exceedingly. And you are saying, from where to where? How is that possible? If you had told me that about 70 years ago, I would have said, yes, it's possible. Even then, how much seed can I, even at 21, have inside of me for you to multiply me exceedingly? But this is God saying, I will make a covenant, I will multiply you. Behold, my covenant is with thee, and thou shalt be a father of many nations. Today, one of the favorite songs is, Abraham's blessings are mine. Even Jesus said in the New Testament, concerning the lady bent double, how can this daughter of Abraham, how can this daughter of Abraham be left captive in this kind of situation? Who is Abraham father of today? Number one, is the father of the Jews, of the people of Palestine, and by connection, father also of the sons of Japheth, okay? Who is he father of? Guess what? His father of the Christians. His father of the Christians, by ingratiation into the body of the Jews. They are ingratiated into that body, so is their father. And guess what? Who is the father of? His father of the Muslims also, the followers and the children and the descendants of Ishmael. So there you go, Isaac, Ishmael, and Jesus Christ. Father Abraham had many sons. Many sons had Father Abraham. I want to tell somebody here today, once God has said it, it is going to become. Once God has said it, it is going to become. Once God has said it, it is going to become. And what has God said concerning you? I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prospereth. I wish above all things. That's what God said. What has God said about you? You shall be head, you shall not be tail. Above only, never beneath. What has God said? All things are working together for your good. It is the way that God wants it. It's intentional. All things working together for your good. What has God said? There's no temptation that cometh to man, but such that is common to man. In that same temptation, he will make a way of escape. What has God said? After you have suffered a little while, after you have suffered just a little while, he will strengthen you, he will bless you, he will settle you. He will strengthen you, he will bless you, he will encourage you, he will settle you. That's what God has said. What has God said? Say to the righteous, it shall be well with him. I want to tell somebody that is going to end well. No more tears. That your daughter, she's going to rise from the bed of sickness. No more tears. That your son, God is going to strengthen his feet. No more tears. It's going to end well. I remember many, many years ago, I went for a program in Alausa, one of the churches there. And as I was finishing that program, a little boy, looked like a little boy, but was a young adult in a wheelchair, looking scattered, looking scrumpy, looking hungry, walked up to me and says, "Man of God, please help me. Please help me. Look at my condition. I've not eaten for days. No money, nothing, no future. Can't complete school. Please help me." It was a day, an ordinary day. I don't know if the young boy knew that I was going to be there or not. I don't know if he had heard about me or not. I don't know what even made him come to look for me that day. But this is almost about 12 or 13 years ago. But from that day till today, I have been looking after that boy. Sent him to school, sent him to computer school, graduated, got him a job. Now the young fellow is a banker, and his bank has brought him a motorized wheelchair. Went to massage for him, all manners of treatment and everything. Even got him a beautiful wife. Who says that God has forgotten you? God will never leave you. I will never forsake you. Better believe.